I'm Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making chicken pot pie. This is a very simple recipe and has only a few items, but it's really tasty and I think you'll like it. Let's start with the chicken. We have some fresh chicken here, and you'll notice what I have is a package of these chicken tenders. This package that I bought came like this with the top on it, and it was 2 pounds. I decided I needed about 1 pound of chicken, so I took out half of it. There were 9 of the chicken tenders, so I took 4.5 of them and I washed them, and then I patted them dry with paper towel, and you can see I've been chopping on them. You just use some kitchen shears, and depending on the size of chunks you want, remembering this is a chicken pot pie, you might want to go down the middle and then just cut it like this. So when we finish, what we have is 1 pound of chunks of raw chicken. So I'm going to come back and season this up. And what I need is some salt and pepper. So I have my salt here, and I just have my regular shaker. The pepper, you can use just some ground pepper that you shake on it, or you can grind your own. And then what you need to do is have a skillet over here. I've got a skillet. I'm going to turn it on. It's been on already, so it's warm, but it's not quite hot enough yet. What I have done is put 2 tablespoons, this is my little 2 tablespoon container, of extra virgin olive oil. I've already put that in here, so I'm going to heat that up, and it looks like it's to the point where I can go ahead and place these in. I'd rather it be sizzling hot, and then I'll turn it down. But if it's not quite that hot, it's okay. You can hear some sizzle, so that's going to be fine. And you can work more with that chicken meat. I didn't really rub it around to get all of the salt in it. You probably would want to do that, but I think so. And then get something to stir this with, and then turn it down, because it's going to have a tendency to pop a little bit. So I'm going to go away and get our chicken done, get it all browned up, come back and make that lovely chicken pot pie. So here's what your chicken chunks look like after you have them browned up on the stove. I'm just putting them off on to a tray that has some paper toweling. If I need to pour off some grease, then I just pour it off into a mayonnaise jar that eventually goes in the garbage. But I can collect a lot of that and get rid of it when I don't need it as I'm cooking. So now I'm going to let that rest for just a moment. In fact, I'll take it off that hot plate and talk about this. This is 1 can of chicken broth. It's a 15-ounce can or a 14.5-ounce can. And it can be any brand that you like, but you should pick a brand that you are familiar with and you know the flavor of, because some of the most expensive brands really don't taste good to me. So this is a cheaper brand, but it tastes wonderful. Bring that to a boil, and then you're going to add your vegetables to that stock. The vegetables will be green peas and carrots. These are crinkle cut carrots and just regular sized peas. I have, I think, 14 ounces. The carrots are 1 pound, and then these are 14 ounces. So I want about half of each bag. It doesn't really matter, just kind of get some vegetables that will be cooked in broth. About 8 ounces or so. So half of that's still left there. And then for this one, about 7 or 8 ounces. And that immediately stopped boiling, so I'm going to turn that up a bit to get that back, and we'll put those back in the freezer for some other use later on. And what I plan to do here is make just a little gravy, and then I'll be building the sauce that goes with the chicken pot pie along with this gravy. In this gravy, I'm going to have 1/2 cup of chicken broth. And you notice I have the same kind of broth here, and it's just 1/2 cup, and I'm putting into that 1/4 cup of cornstarch. And you can see my box here, just cornstarch. And I'm going to stir that around I'm grabbing a spoon right here. I want this to be combined before I put it in that skillet. So I'm going to pour in the cornstarch mixture right in there, just like making gravy almost. And I know I will need some of this, if not all, and maybe even another can, but this will give you an idea of how we start. And I need something to stir that around, and I think I have it turned off right now. So I'll just cook it over low, keep an eye on it, keep stirring it, and I'll cook these until they are done, and then I'll be back. This is what your chicken pot pie gravy looks like after you've added one can of chicken stock to that mixture. Well, part of it came in that can, mixture of chicken stock and 1/4 cup of cornstarch. It's very thick, but what we have over here are our cooked vegetables, cooked in broth. What I'm going to do is ladle these over here. These have cooked about 5 minutes, and there's a lot of extra stock. So I'm going to use as much stock as I need to come up with a nice gravy, a nice texture. This is too thick, so it needs to be thinned down, so I will be using some of that. I'll come back and show you what it looks like when it goes in the pie dish. I have put about half of the liquid that was left from cooking the peas and carrots in here, and this is bubbling very nicely, so it's time for the chicken to go in. But I still can work with this in terms of making it thinner because of that leftover broth. So I'm going to stir this around a little bit, and when it is to a good consistency, it's going to go into the crust. But you can get the idea of what we're trying to accomplish here. We want a nice mixture of vegetables and stock that is thickened, along with that lovely chicken that we round up earlier. So this is going to be a very chunky and lovely pot pie. So here's the filling for our gorgeous chicken pot pie. And here is the crust. And you might think I got that done awfully easily. I did, because I bought pre-made pie crust. All you have to do is open up the roll and then unroll it and put it down into your pie dish. And so I used a deep dish pie dish and just laid one of these down. Now this is gonna be the top. So let me get this spooned in, give me a minute, and I'll come back. I'll have the top on and we'll talk about it from there. So this is exactly the skillet full. It was the right size. If it had not been, if it had been more than this could take, what I'd have is a small Pyrex dish, and I would bake that in the oven alongside this one, and it would be crustless. And that would be a perfect dish for some of you that have been asking me for main course diet dishes. Leave the crust off of this. It's great for a diet. It is very low in calorie, low in fat. It's got that good chicken and good vegetables in it. And for those cans of chicken broth, they're 5 calories per cup. So that would be something easy for you to do. I'm just finishing the fluting of the edges. If you want to, you can just press them together. But if you want something that's roughly, you can do it with your fingers, just pressing like that and moving along, and the two halves go together. Now it's really important that you put some slits in the top, because you want some vents for the steam to come out. So just take some kitchen shears and make whatever design you want. I'm in a little bit of a hurry here, so I'm just going to make this very simple. Just kind of a cross shape at the beginning, and maybe a couple of others, and then it will be in the oven at 350 degrees for maybe 20, 25, 30 minutes. I'll keep track of the time and let you know. I let my chicken pot pie bake for 20 minutes in a 350 degree oven. And honestly, the chicken pot pie portion itself was done before it went in. It was a matter of getting the crust done and crisped up. But we don't have to worry about anything being raw, because everything was edible that went into that pie. So I'm just going to scoop in here. You don't have to cut it in pie slices. In fact, it will not hold together. It's soupy and juicy. So I'm just going to go down and get a good portion and try to get some crust as well as some of the filling and show you what it looks like. And it's going to be a wonderful dish. I kept it really simple with the two vegetables and the meat. If you would like to add any other vegetables, feel free. You can use potatoes, onions, celery, mushrooms, Anything that appeals to you. I'm trying to get some of that crust and some more of the meat here. So that's what you expect from your chicken pot pie. And I'm going to serve it over here. And when I eat it, I like a little extra grind of fresh black pepper. That makes it taste just a little extra special. So there you go. I hope you enjoy that.